morning. It's so good to be here with you this morning. We're going to stand and sing some songs this morning. We are starting with the books of the Bible, and our verse today is coming from Proverbs. Would you stand up and sing with me?
The books of the Bible, time-tested and reliable. Scripture has a power that's undeniable. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, Job, and Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, Joel, and Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, and Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, Malachi. The books of the Bible, their wisdom's verifiable. Scripture has a power that's undeniable. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, Acts and Romans, 1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians, Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, Thessalonians 1 and 2, 1 Timothy, 2 Timothy, Titus, Philemon, Hebrews, James, 1 and 2 Peter, 1 and 2 John,
3 John,
Jude and Revelation, the books of the Bible, time-tested and reliable. Now you know all 66 books of the Bible.
All right, nice job, boys and girls. Even though we didn't do it last week, I think you still remembered it really well. So I'm going to introduce a new song to you this morning, and it's one of my very favorites. It has a whole lot of repeats in it. So just listen well the first time, and then I think you should be able to sing it with me the second.
O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
Sing that with me.
O Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. The heavens declare your greatness. The oceans cry out to you. The mountains, they bow down before you. So I'll join with the
same thing again.
O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. The heavens declare your greatness. The oceans cry out. Bow down before
job, boys and girls. For the very first time singing that, you did an amazing job. All right, and we are going to end our singing this morning with No Longer Slaves.
You unravel me with a melody, you surround me with a song of deliverance from my enemies, till all my fears are gone. I'm no longer a slave to fear. I am a child.
Boys and girls, please take a seat.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. How's everyone doing? Good. All right. Well, I love worshiping with you all and hearing you sing those songs. What a blessing to my heart. And I know that the Lord was blessed by your worship as well. All right. Before we pray for our chapel speaker today, let's quickly practice our chapel verses. John 1, verse 12. And it says, yet to all who did receive him, to those who in his name he gave the right to become children of God. John 1:12. I want you guys to stand up And let's say that nice and bold, because it's exciting to be able to, like, he gave us the right to become children of God. So I want to hear you guys say nice and loud the whole thing. All right? Ready? Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. John 1:12. Thanks. You guys can have a seat. Sometimes standing up just makes us feel more confident, because you guys sure sounded more confident singing it or saying it as you were standing up. And then this month we've been learning from 1 Timothy 4:12 that says, don't let anyone look down on you because you are, but set an example for the believers in. Do you remember the different things in speech, in conduct, in love, then in faith? I heard somebody say faith, and in purity. So it's speech, conduct, love, faith, and impurity. So in all these ways, we can set examples for other believers, no matter how young or how old you are. All right? Well, this morning, I'm excited to have Mrs. Kennedy come and lead our chapel message. And so as she gets ready to come, I want to pray for her. So you guys, will you join me as we pray? God, I thank you that we no longer have to be slaves of fear, because, Lord, we are your children, and we can be bold and we can be confident, Lord, because we know we've got you on our side. God, I just pray for our chapel message this morning that you will use it just to bless our hearts. I thank you for Mrs. Kennedy. I thank you for how she loves you and, Lord, how she wants to help children learn to follow you and love you as well. So I pray that you will use her words in a special way this morning. It's in Jesus' name that I pray. Amen.
Good morning, everybody. Oh, my goodness. I think you might still be asleep. Good morning, everybody. That's more like it. Good morning, everybody, in your classrooms as well. This morning, I would like to share with you about our character of the month. Okay? And there it is, loyalty. Now, the word loyalty means not giving up on other people, stick togetherness. Okay? Our wonderful principal has put together some things that we as teachers look for in you to help us to determine loyalty. One is, I will serve my family and teachers. I will encourage others in hard times. I will not mock authorities. I will point out the good in others. I will honor my country. Now, I put these up because with loyalty, there's always a word that I think of when I hear that word, and it's the word relationship. And if you notice, all of these I wills have to do with other people. They don't have to do with me or you. I will serve my family and teachers, encourage others. I will not mock authority. I will point out good things, okay, in others. And I will honor my country. All of these have to do with other people, not us. How we treat other people, our relationships with them. And when I thought about that word relationship, there is a woman in the Bible who is like a hero to me, because she is like the best friend anyone could ever have. And her name is Ruth. So I would like to share with you a little bit about the story of Ruth and her mother-in-law named Naomi. And this is from the Bible, all right? Now, Ruth was strong and steady, okay? The stomachs were growling throughout Judah, okay? Shake your head if you've ever had a time you were so hungry that your tummy growled, yeah? All right? There was a reason all the tummies were grumbling. There was a famine in the land. Now, that means that the crops were not growing well. There was either not enough rain or it was too hot. Something was keeping the crops from growing. So there was a famine and people were hungry. The food crisis was so severe that even the little children did not have enough to eat. Now, as a mommy, I know mommies and daddies always make sure our children get food first. We make sure your tummies are full, right? Yeah? But it was so bad that the mommies and daddies didn't even have enough food to make sure their children were not hungry. So Naomi and her husband lived in Bethlehem, and they had two sons. So they were in a crisis. They were desperate to find food, right? They were so desperate to find food for their family that they left their friends and all their relatives, and they moved to a new place called Moab. It was a nearby country across the Jordan River. But sadly, while there, Naomi's husband died. He passed away. And then she was left with just her two sons. Now, in Moab, her two sons met two beautiful women and married them. So now she had two sons and two daughter-in-laws. And so she had a lot of support, a lot of help. But then tragedy struck again. Both of her sons died. And now she's left with her two daughter-in-laws, Ruth and Orpah, okay, and Orpah. And so she's left with them. Now, these are three women all along in a new land, and they're looking for food. They're hungry. But things do get a little bit better for them, okay? Judah, where Naomi had first come from, in the land of Judah, there was now recovered from this famine. So Naomi and her two daughter-in-laws returned to Bethlehem. They went back to live near Naomi's family. Because we all know family helps each other, right? So Naomi said, I'm going to move back with my family. So she told the two girls, she said, girls, I'm going back to be with my family. Why don't you go back and be with your family? And that way your family can help you and make sure you have food and that you're safe. Well, the first daughter-in-law, Orpah, said, yes, I'm going to go back to my family. But not Ruth. Ruth said, Naomi, wherever you go, I'm going to go. And wherever you stay, I'm going to stay. Oh. Okay, I'm sorry. Wherever you go, I'm going to go. And your people are going to become my people. All right? So Ruth says, I'm sticking with you. I'm sticking like a friend. I'm going to make sure you're okay because you don't have sons and daughters, and I'm going to make sure you're safe. So that's what she did. She stayed with her. Now, while they were in Bethlehem, and this is a picture of her telling Naomi that she's going to stay with her. All right. Orpah returned home, and Ruth stayed. Thank you for your patience. You're being so kind. Ruth went out into the fields to work to gather food. And while she was there, she met a man named Boaz. Now, Boaz was a part of Naomi's family, and Boaz fell in love with Ruth, and he married her. And God blessed them. And Ruth actually became the great-great-grandmother of Jesus. You see, Ruth was faithful to Naomi. When things got hard, when they didn't have food, did Ruth run off and leave her to run home? No. When they were left all alone and didn't really have anywhere to live, and Ruth had to leave her family to go be with Naomi, did she grumble and complain about it? No. She was a true friend to Naomi. She loved Naomi. She respected her. She wanted the best for Naomi. So Ruth was willing to sacrifice her own feelings. She was willing to sacrifice her own family and her own land that she had come from to make sure that Naomi was taken care of. Ruth was a great friend. Now, Ruth and Naomi had a relationship. They were mother-in-law and daughter-in-law. But they were beyond that. They were friends. They took care of each other and helped each other. Their relationship was based on love and respect for one another. They both chose to be loyal to each other, and Ruth especially loyal to Naomi. We also can choose to be loyal to others. In Proverbs chapter 17, verse 7a, it says, a friend loves at all times. So you guys help me out. I'm going to ask a question, and I want you to shout yes or no, okay? Do we love our friends when they're kind to us? Do we love our friends when they do not share? Does the verse say we don't have to love our friends if they're not sharing? No, it says we love them when? At all times. Do we love our friends when they hurt our feelings? Yes. Do we hurt our friends? Do we love our friends when they encourage us? Yes. Do we love our friends when they've hurt our feelings? Yes. We love our friends all the time. Because can we control how another person is doing? Can we control if our friend is grumpy? Can we control if our friend is being unkind? Can we control if our friend doesn't want to share? No. But can we control how we treat them? Yes. When our friend is grumpy, can we still be kind to them? When our friend doesn't want to share, can we still share with them? Yes. We can always choose how we want to treat them back. Now, sometimes, though, it's so hard. Our friend is so unkind to us, and we just fold our arms up and say, I'm so mad at you. I don't even want to be your friend anymore. Oh, my goodness. Is that loving each other at all times? No. Or we may look at our friend and say, you're not being kind. I'm going to tell the teacher on you. Is that loving at all times? No. Guys, in our class in third grade, we are learning a lot about making choices. Like every day when we get up, we can choose to either be grumpy or we can choose to put a smile on our face. We can choose to be unkind and treat others poorly, or we can choose to be an example of kindness. So as a good friend, we love our friends all the time. If our friends are grumpy, we give them a big smile and say, I'm sorry you're having a rough day. I will pray for you. If our friend is being unkind, we can say something like, you know, that kind of hurt my feelings, but I love you and I forgive you for that. Would it make you feel better if we played together at recess? You're not sharing with me, and that is hurting my feelings. Would you like to share what I have instead? We can always make a choice to offer a better option than being grumpy, unkind, or not sharing. By the choices we make, and good friends always choose to put their other friend first. Even when that person is not being a good friend, we can still be a good friend because we love at when? Oh, tell me again. We love our friends when? So, in other words, no matter what they do, we choose love, right? I have a poster in my classroom that says, always choose kindness. Today, I want to challenge you to always choose love. Even when you don't feel the other person showing you love, you don't know. They may have really had a very bad day. They may not have slept well last night, and so not having enough sleep has made them upset. Or there may be something going on. Maybe someone they love is sick, or maybe their puppy is not feeling well. And so it's made them sad, and it's caused them to be grumpy or unkind or not share. We don't know what someone else is going through, but we can always choose to be kind. We can always choose to love. And there is a song that I love, and it's not from the Bible. It's not a song from the Bible. However, the Bible does speak a lot about friendship. And it's a song that I'm sure most of you know about friendship. And it just reminded me of Ruth and Naomi. How when things got rough, Ruth didn't run away. She stayed on that rough road with Naomi. Okay? And they stuck together like glue, no matter what. They were there to support each other. So I'm going to ask my class to come up. If Clara will come up first and the rest follow. And I'm going to ask you to put your mask on if you don't have it on, because this is a song that you probably know, and so we encourage you to sing along with us. I'm not going to have you stand because I want you to be able to see the girls and boys, but you please sing along with us. It's a fun song, and they're lining up, so we'll give them just a second. All right. Again, this is a song that you probably know. You are more than welcome to sing with us, because when things get rough, when the day is long, we can be good friends to each other. Today, when you have the challenge of someone who may be a little grumpy or a little unkind or unwilling to share, I would love for you to look at them and say, "You got a friend in me. I got your back. I'm going to love you at all times because God wants me to be your friend and to show you kindness every day in every way." Can we end in prayer, please? Lord, we thank you so much for the gift of friendship. We thank you that we have friends in our classroom and in our school that we can play with at recess, friends that we can do projects with in the classroom, friends we can laugh with and enjoy things together, but also friends that will pray for us, friends who will give us a hug when we really need one, friends who give us nice things, little gifts, little cards and letters that say, "I love you." We thank you for those relationships, God, and today we just ask that you help us to be friends that will give you glory, friends who are kind, respectful, and loving at all times. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thank you, guys.